For us, query will be the most complex of the required content provider methods. We've given you the bones of the query operation. As you can see, we use our SURI matcher object once again to switch on the type of URI. Note that each response from this function will return a cursor that corresponds to the incoming query as defined by the URI. This is the only function where we will have to fill out a different response for every type of URI in the content provider, as several of them are used in queries only. At the bottom of our function, we're going to set the notification URI for our cursor to the one that was passed into the function. This causes the cursor to register a content observer, to watch for changes that happen to that URI and any of its descendants. This allows the content provider to easily tell the UI when the cursor changes, on operations like a database insert or update. We'll see more on this later when we cover inserting and updating the database. Uncomment the test basic weather query function within test provider, and run this code when you're finished to make sure all of this is working well.